Runway Gen 2 has changed a lot in the past year. They've added a lot of new features like the Motion Brush tool, which lets you control how specific parts of your AI videos move.
And the really cool lip sync feature.
In this video, we'll go over all the basics of using Runway for text to video and image to video. And by the end of this tutorial, you'll know how to use all the cool features that Runway has to make the best AI videos. Spoiler alert, while Runway is one of the best AI video generators out there, it still has some flaws that you should know about. Here's the homepage. This is what you'll see when you first log in. We'll go to Generate Videos, which pulls up the AI video tools, and the first thing we'll start with is text to video. In the basic interface, we have the settings in the workspace on the left, and on the right is where the AI videos will be generated. Now, we could upload an image as an image reference, but for now, let's just start with the text prompt. Inside the prompt bar, I'll write, "A bird with black and yellow feathers lands on a sunflower." There's a big purple generate button, which will create a 4-second video based on the prompt. But I'm actually going to start by using the free previews button over here, which will generate 4 sample images for us. If we hover over one of them and click use as image input, the image will be pasted as a reference into our video generation interface. So now if we generate a video, the first frame of the video will be exactly the same as the image. Typically these take 1 or 2 minutes to finish generating. I'd recommend you to always use the free image previews. This lets you make sure that the visual style and content of the video is exactly what you wanted. The bird and flower are animated with some motions, although there's a little bit of distortion. It looks like an eye gets generated onto the bird. It is hard to get high quality videos that have a lot of movement in them without some kind of distortion. Let's remove this image reference and take a look at the general settings. We can pick between 720p and 2K resolution. Higher resolution does take longer to generate. There's this prompt weight. It supposedly makes the preview images generated follow the prompt more closely when you increase the value. I found that this wasn't necessarily the case. For me, it's okay to just leave this as a default value. The negative prompt is where you enter what should not appear inside the preview photos. So if I add in grass, green, and leaves in here, the preview images will be a bit more barren without as much vegetation in them. But keep in mind that the negative prompt only applies to the preview images and not necessarily the videos themselves. Using the same seed means that you'll generate the exact same images every time. I usually leave this turned off. Interpolate increases visual frame rate, so your videos are smoother. And if you purchase a subscription, you'll have the option to remove the Runway watermark. One cool feature that Runway has introduced is a bunch of preset visual styles that you can add into your videos. This time we'll prompt for a scenic tropical island with palm trees and waves on a bright sunny day. AI video generators in general do pretty well with landscape type of prompts. Inside the style menu, there's a bunch of preset visual styles we can pick from. There's a large variety from cinematic styles to anime and illustration styles. You can find one for just about any situation you need. And looking at the resulting videos, the styles do in fact make a big difference in the way that they look. By the way, you can download the videos by hovering over them and then using this downwards pointing arrow. To change the aspect ratio, use this menu here, which toggles between a bunch of different options. There's vertical and horizontal options, and even the ultra-wide cinematic 21:9 aspect ratio. Let's try prompting for a person. Back to the prompt bar, I'll type close-up shot of a young Asian woman on a rooftop in Paris during golden hour. A really cool feature is this light bulb icon, which is the enhanced prompt tool. The AI takes a prompt you've entered and automatically enhances it with descriptive details. So it looks like they've added in the Eiffel Tower into our prompt. Let's create some free preview images first. The structure of the faces look decent for the most part. You'll notice that they do look kind of smooth and photo brushed without too much intricate details. But these types of images will work fine for video generation. If you have faces that are overly detailed, the AI is going to degrade the quality of those details anyways. It's pretty consistent and there's some decent motion. There is an option to extend the video length by 4 seconds. You can do this all the way up to a total of 16 seconds. The thing is though, if you extend the videos, it's very common for some amount of distortion to occur. If we take a look over here after the 4-second mark, you'll notice the lighting of the face change. This is really common across all AI video generators that I've seen. The torso of the character can also deform into something else, so I wouldn't count on this video extension to work super well. One feature that does work really well though is the camera motions feature. Here's a preview image of a small Viking town done in anime style. If we use the camera settings tab, we can see a bunch of different options for how the camera should move in the generated video, including panning, tilting, and rotating. The really cool thing is that when we adjust these sliders, this purple rectangle which hovers over the reference image will show the final position of what the camera will see. So you can get a really good idea of what the final video will look like. I've added on a couple of different motions, and the generated video looks pretty good. I mean, it follows the motions exactly like it shows in the preview. Like I said, the AI is pretty solid when it comes to landscape videos. Don't try to add in too much motion though. If we max out these sliders and push the limits, you'll start to see some warping and distortion. A nice tip is that if you use the extend video feature, you can actually add in new camera motions for the extended video. There's also the option to use the motion brush feature here. We'll come back to this in a minute. Runway works best when animating images generated by Runway itself, but you do have the option of uploading your own pictures to animate into videos. Just drag and drop your photo into the prompt reference. To get the best results, you want to use 2K resolution images, and I'd avoid photos with a ton of fine-grained details, since those won't be preserved by the AI for the most part. Pictures that have complex motions in the arms and legs are probably going to get distorted a bit, so when trying to animate photos of people, I'd avoid any complicated movements. Adding some animation to close-up shots of faces or still poses does work pretty well for the most part. If there's a set of video options you like, you can save them with the presets feature. So let's say I have the options of a cartoon illustration style and also a 9:16 vertical aspect ratio. I can use the presets feature and name it something like cartoon vertical. If I reset the settings back to the defaults and enter some prompt like a superhero on the moon, underneath I'll have the option to apply the cartoon vertical settings to my generation job. A really cool and unique feature specific to Runway is the motion brush tool, which lets you control the movement on specific parts of your video. So I've uploaded this image of a sailboat and entered the prompt, a sailboat in the ocean. If I generate a video like this, there's not a lot of movement. Everything kind of just stays still. What I can do to adding some additional movement is using the motion brush. Inside the feature interface, I'll use a brush and paint over the sailboat. Then I can adjust this horizontal motion slider to tell the AI I want the area that I painted over to move horizontally along the x-axis. There's a total of 5 brushes, so we can get up to 5 custom motions. Let's try using the second brush. First, I'll increase the size of the paintbrush a bit, and this time I'll paint over the clouds. You don't have to paint over the entire object to get it to move. Then I'll have them move vertically along the y-axis, and also have them come a bit closer to us using the proximity motion tool. Finally, I want the waves in the ocean to splash around a little bit. I'm gonna pick the third motion brush and then turn on auto detect area. The AI will automatically detect regions of interest, which makes it a lot easier to select the entire ocean. This ambient noise slider is used for situations like this where you want some ambient environmental movement, like waves or grass blown in the wind. In the generated video, our motion brush instructions are followed. The boat moves to the left, the clouds shift up and slightly towards us, and the waves slosh around a little bit. Here's another example. I have this illustration of a campfire. First, I'll select the moon and have it move diagonally up and to the left. I also want the campfire to have some subtle flame effects, so I'll use the ambient motion tool for that. By the way, if you make a mistake, you can just undo or use this eraser tool to remove any areas that you've painted over. In Runway, there is a video-to-video AI, which can take an input video and convert it into a different visual style. First, we'll drag in a video and wait for it to process. My video has finished uploading. Now, we can pick from a bunch of different preset visual styles to convert our video into. Think of this like a visual filter. Then we can set the style strength for how much of the style you want to transfer over. The truth though is that right now this feature doesn't really work that well. The simpler parts of the video, like the building, sidewalk, and general silhouette of the subject look okay, but any complex motions like the arms overlapping will get distorted. I wouldn't recommend using this feature for now. One feature that does work really well though is the lip sync feature. Let's head over to the lip sync interface. Inside, I'll paste a couple of sentences that I want to get narrated. There's a ton of different voices you can pick from. I'm going with Claudia, who has this British accent.
Oh, me? I'm Claudia, and you are?
We can choose from a list of existing faces to animate. Any of these will work well. But I'll actually choose from one of my own uploaded images. The AI will both generate the audio based on the script we wrote, and also lip sync the audio to the image that we've uploaded.
Nefertari was no ordinary scribe. She possessed a rare gift, a deep connection to the stories of the past.
You can also do this inside the video generation pipeline. After generating a video animation of a person, you can directly use the lip sync feature. Just enter a script and pick a voice. The AI will do the rest. This feature works best if you use a video without too much head movement.
When she wrote, the words seemed to come alive, painting vivid images in the minds of those who read them.
As for organizing your videos, all of your assets can be found in the Asset Management page. By default, the AI videos are saved inside the Gen 2 folder. We can create a new folder, and I'll just call it Project Zero. Then you can directly drag and drop videos inside here. If you want the videos you've generated to be saved inside this folder by default, go to the video generation interface and find the folder management icon. Then navigate to Project Zero and select it as a default folder. Now, anytime we create a video, it'll be automatically saved to the Project Zero folder. Let's test that out real quick. I'll go with something like a man on a World War I battlefield. Then if we generate the video, we can confirm that it's saved into the Project Zero folder. As far as pricing is concerned, Runway is pretty expensive. The standard plan costs $15 a month and comes with 625 credits. 5 credits gets you 1 second of video, so this is really only around 2 minutes of video. You can also purchase additional 1,000 credits for $10. Which comes out to about 3 more minutes of video. Given the fact that it can take multiple tries to get a video that works well for you, the prices can add up pretty quickly. Even though it is pricey, Runway is still one of the better AI video generators out there. The technology for AI video is still in its infancy, so any other AI video generators out there will also have a lot of the same problems that Runway has. But if you get creative, you can do some pretty cool stuff with it. If you're interested in seeing what another AI video generator looks like, go and check out this video tutorial I made on Pika Labs. It's got a few different features that Runway doesn't have.
Nefertari was no ordinary scribe. She possessed a rare gift, a deep connection to the stories of the past. When she wrote, the words seemed to come alive, painting vivid images in the minds of those who read them.